Welcome to this video. Tonight I'll try to pick a challenge lock from a unknown maker, but the lock is called the Crappy Lock. It is written on a piece of paper around it right there. So here's the bidding on a key. The key is really nice, by the way. It is a Corbin. So the lock works well. Trying to pick this guy. So I'm gonna use a slightly larger tension wrench. Okay, there we go. So let's go. Okay, so number two gives me a big falset to start with. If I go towards the back, don't get anything. Pin number one gave me a little something more on the core. So number two is giving me counter rotation now. Okay, let's try it again. I think I got it picked. I'm struggling to get my falset back. Let me counter rotation. I think I got it picked. Okay, something in the back gave me counter. Number one. Number one wants some more. Alright, got my full set back. Number three. Number one. Some more counter rotation on one. Something going on with pin number one. Can't wait to see what kind of pin is in there. Hopefully I'm not overset and getting counter rotation from the key pin. So honestly, that's what it actually feels like. Maybe something going on with pin number one, and it just doesn't want to go. I can't get a good grip with the thin pick I had. So let's try with this guy. Oh, there we go. We're open. Now let's gut this guy. It's called really, really crappy lock. That's what it's called. I'm gonna use the key. Sorry, I'm gonna have to shim this guy. So just by the looks of it, it looks like a whole bunch of standard pins in there. So standard number one, number two standard, number four standard. Ooh, five had a ball bearing in there. Interesting. And there is milling that's been done on chamber number four. No threading. Oh, a little bit of counter milling on number one. So counter milling on number one and some milling on the around the key pin number four. Really interesting. And in chamber number five, there was, I'll show you a bit later, all of these, but there was a ball bearing and a driver pin in slot number five. So let's see what's on top. Yes, pool. Standard driver number two, the copper spring. Get the shim out. Okay. We got another spool in number three with a steel spring. So all the springs are different. We'll go from the back. Really strong spring in the sixth chamber. Spring just don't want to come out. Number, whoa, what the heck is that? Huge driver pin, never seen that before. And another standard driver. Wow. So that's sixth. This one is here. There we go. So if I look in there. Don't see any work on the top. So, oops, sorry. This is really interesting stuff. So, number one was a steel spring with a spool on top. Number two was a standard stack, standard driver, standard keep-in, spool on top, standard keep-in, standard driver, steel keep-in. And look at this guy. So this guy had no spring. It was just in there like that, super long driver with a driver and a ball bearing as the keep-in. And then we got a steel keep-in with a slightly serrated driver. So if I remember right, the milling was in number one, so catching on that spool, and number four. So there was a lot of milling for standard stack. Maybe I would have inverted these two. Might have been a little harder like that, but and then you get all different springs. So there you have it. So that was the really crappy lock from an unknown builder. So whoever made that lock, thank you very much for the lock, and thanks for watching.